Is there a place nearby to go to the restroom after this is over?
There are restrooms over there.
Will they be open?
Yes, so do you know what a mushroom is? Put metal mushroom into the microphone and in the building with metal mushroom. Yes,
because I have a 2-hour trip.
Well, thank you for being here.
Yeah.
Hey guys, I just wanted to let you know we are live streaming from up here, so any conversations you have will be recorded in case that influences the conversations you want to have up here. So it's already started live streaming right now. So if you don't like our singing, you might want to not tell your people.
Oh, I think we're
going to
like
that. Well, I sure like so.
Yeah, we'll be on Facebook and Instagram.
Thank you.
Thank you. not a part of Colonial Williamsburg, which may be a surprise. We're right in the middle of that area. But we get no funding from the Colonial Williamsburg Foundation. If you are interested in having a part in this year, we will encourage you to do something. And maybe we'll have some baskets at each door as you go out. It's not meant to trap you, but we do hope you'll be as generous as possible. This is, sorry to say, I need to tell you to turn off anything that will get into the music at home. I'm not expecting a moment during the conference. That's of course for cell phones, alarm watches, pagers, pacemaker, not pacemaker.
Oh! leave last fall, and I did get a chance to work with them, and I'm feeling complete now that I have a chance to be back working with the students at William & Mary. I would like to introduce our president. Her name is Heather Christensen, and she would like to tell you some things.
Thank you.
springtime, a little bit of summer, but lots about spring flowers, nothing about pollen, but if you live in Williamsburg, you know that's the overarching theme these days. We're doing our best to stay hydrated and to sing, and I think they're doing a marvelous job of fighting through that pollen. Hopefully the rain will wash them away. Our next song, Spring the Sweet Spring, by George Oldroyd, an English composer, on a text by Thomas Nash. And you will hear some bird calls. Cuckoo, cuckoo, dum-dum, witch-a-woo, hooey-hooey to witch-a-woo. I tried today to see if I could get Siri to tell me what each one of those birds was. I've been showing them pictures of birds throughout all of our rehearsals. And I'm asking them to imagine those little birds as they're singing. Just a song about the beauty and the wonder of the world as the rebirth happens.
Thank you.
speaking a lot of English. I've put all the text in your program because I think there's a lot that you can learn from that. We do our best to enunciate, but sometimes it's good to read the poem. And I have to say, while I was typing out the poem the other day, I know it by lines musically in my head, but as I was writing it as just a poem without the music, it had a different reading to me. So I think it's really good for you to be able to take that in and maybe read it even before we sing it. We've talked a lot, perfect for rain today, right? But we talked about a lot about lilacs, the flowers, and this piece is about a person who was in a relationship and is no longer in that relationship, but the smell of the lilacs after the rain, that wonderful fragrance, brings this person back to a memory of what life was like while they were in that relationship. And they almost have this kind of out-of-body experience, imagining that person has come back to them. And then at the end of the piece, we realize, obviously, that it doesn't happen that way. However, we've talked about this too, it's a minor key piece, but the last chord ends with the picky third with the F sharp major. So the alto sing that right F sharp, like life will go on and everything will be okay. So there's a positive note to the end of this beautiful, beautiful piece.
I could cry with the sweetness of despair. Jericho, Jericho, Jericho.
last year called New Dreams, and we had the opportunity to do a Zoom call with her, to sing for her, and then have her give us information and kind of guide us through it. I'm also with the Bodhisattva Chamber Singers. We have a concert tomorrow, and we're also doing two pieces by her. One is the world premiere that we got invited to do. I just love the way she writes her voices, and she's really kind of engaged currently in kind of political music and social movement. This is a poem written by, I just realized it was premiered by the Concord Women's Chorus in Concord, Massachusetts, and one of the women from the group wrote this poem. So you have the text in front of you. We've talked a little bit about how it's coming out of your shell and loving the person that you were, but also respecting the person that you're becoming, and kind of being caught in between those two worlds and then moving forward. And I think triumphantly we move forward at the end of this. So we've asked Justin to come back and play, but I need to introduce you to Sarah Rosenkanzer, who is... I'm afraid it will take me the rest of the evening to tell you what she's been up to lately. She is the recent Coachella competition winner of the William & Mary Symphony Orchestra. Today at noontime, she gave her senior recital, which was outstanding. She also played at a recital at 4 o'clock this afternoon, and when I asked her if she would play tonight, she's like, oh sure, I'd love to do it. I only have 3 other gigs that day. And I'm like, she never ever says no, this beautiful, beautiful person. And she's a music major with a double in allied health kinesiology, and she will be getting her master's in nursing at UVA School of Nursing starting in the fall. Maybe not even the summer.
Yeah.
So we're exceptionally thrilled to have her here playing with us. We hope you enjoy our final piece, Grown One. Thank you. Nancy Marsden, they're doing it there. Come on now. Anybody else that wants to come and sing? And this is not a cheap standing ovation, but we do expect that you will stand for the singing of our own. It's no time.
Oh.